New data shows about half of all millennials are not buying health insurance. Now, that's bad news for Obamacare. Is it because millennials feel invincible? Why buy health insurance when you're incredibly healthy and young? Here to weigh in is Ashley Pratte from Young America's Foundation. This is an important question, Ashley, because Obamacare needs you youngsters. You're young, you're healthy, they want your money to pay into the system. So why are you not signing up?
Well, I think you hit the nail right on the head when you said that we feel invincible. And I'm a millennial, and I'm included in that. You're young, you're active, you're healthy, you don't foresee any major medical conditions affecting you. So what is the incentive to purchasing health insurance when it's a cost that you don't see a tangible benefit to? You can go out and spend your money on an iPhone as opposed to health insurance.
But you would, I mean, most millennials would get a subsidy because most millennials don't earn that much money at that stage in life. So it's not like it's going to cost you very much money. You do get a subsidy.
Yes, well, so the rates are lower, but one thing that has been seen under Obamacare is that the tab is being picked up by millennials specifically, so our rates are actually going up. And now the subsidy argument that you're actually making, now there's a, I believe, something going to the Supreme Court about subsidies and Obamacare, because now it might not be legal at the federal level and might just only apply to state level. So I think that there's a multitude of issues here that can affect millennials when it comes to purchasing Obamacare through the exchanges. And we also have to remember that it was peddled to young people as a free health care program, and now they're the ones expected to pick up the bill here for the older and sicker generation too.
We've spent a lot of time on the program today talking about millennials as a very special and separate group of people.
Oh, we are.
Well, you are. That's the truth. You really changed the way of entertainment. You're into streaming. Mm-hmm. You've changed communication, social networks, for example. You've changed technology. You use smartphones big time. You've changed food. You're like expensive burgers. You like health food. You want to know where the food has come from. I mean, you are
I still love McDonald's and Wendy's, so I don't know.
Excellent.
You got one millennial on your side.
But look, you are a definable group which has had a very significant impact on society as a whole. Mm-hmm. That's who you are.
Yes, and the trends are definitely different, too, with young people, and I think a lot of that, and we're seeing a lot of different, you know, companies pander to young people too. But healthcare is something that we will choose to forego if we feel healthy. And I think another thing to look at here too that actually scares me about our generation is that we never have more than $375 on hand. So if an emergency were to happen, how could we afford it? And I think this economy has impacted our generation negatively in a sense that we have become a part-time millennial generation.
So why does your group keep voting for collectivists?
Well, that's a great question.
I mean, I'm sorry, but you do. You don't vote for individual liberty and freedom and capitalism and profit and dynamism and prosperity. You don't vote for that. Why?
But the sad thing is, when we're looking at polling, we're seeing that young people actually believe in capitalism. They believe in free markets. They believe in less federal government regulation. So what we need to do is really take that message out there and say, you know, this is what conservatism means, and this is what liberals are pitching to you. When has a liberal policy actually helped a young person? I can look back to when Barack Obama first got into office and he promised all of these things for young people. Now what we're seeing is the youth unemployment rate, the highest it's ever been at 18.1%. Millennials are on their couches in their parents' basement, and you see Pajama Boy becoming, you know, the person that represents our generation.
Did you find that sad? Did you find Pajama Boy at all attractive?
Oh, gosh, no. I thought that that was the worst thing that administration could have done to peddle that Obamacare program. You know, there is nothing more embarrassing than depicting a whole generation of people basically as couch potatoes because their policies have hurt us so badly that we are forced to be on our parents' couches because we're putting our foot to the ground and looking for jobs and they're just not available.
You have an ideology. You're ideological. You come at questions of current events from an ideological point of view. You're big on markets and freedom. I understand that. But not many millennials are ideological, are they?
Well, I didn't come up through it by being raised in a conservative household or being told conservative things. I learned these things through going through life. I realized that some policies weren't actually benefiting me, that were coming from, you know, this side that's supposed to represent young people, when in fact their policies hurt us. They expect us to pay for their big government policies, and that is detrimental to our economic future. And that's why we're putting off home ownership, marriages, families, and that's going to have a significant impact on our economy here in the United States, Stuart.
You people, you really are changing our society. It's you that's doing it. You people, see? And I'm your grandfather, okay?
Oh, no. You don't look a day over 25.
Well, you can come back anytime you like, young lady. Ashley Pratte, what a pleasure.